Making mistakes, experimentation and play are ways I grow the work. My painting is all about mistakes. I mean, it's my view of the world. Information is in the wrong places, things are misspelled, and I put in what I feel like. I totally control the information. It's my rebellion against being a print designer when I had to lay out magazines and get the copy to fit. Now I make the copy fit because I'm the editor, not somebody else. My father invented a device called stereo templates that corrected the distortion in lenses. He was a photogrammetric engineer, which is the science of the camera. And his specialty was aerial photography. So he was correct. He made a mathematical calculation so that when you blew up photographs, it brought back in the curvature of the Earth, which is pushed away from the photography. So if you're looking at Google Maps today, that wouldn't be possible without the invention he made way back in 1957. And what I learned is that everything that you're looking at is a distortion. And you can see it even when you go on Google Maps and you look at a photographic area where suddenly something is in shadow that isn't in shadow, or there's something there that's foreshortened in a bizarre way that makes the photograph look strange. In that distortion is inaccuracy. And there are inaccuracies in everything we touch, and we accept them as real. If you go to Barnes & Noble and you buy five different maps of Rome right now, you'll find that they don't line up, that the keys for what makes an area type large or small are based on different calculus. If you get a road map of Baltimore, you may find that the highlighted roads are not the biggest roads, but the roads that have a mobile station on it, because you bought the map from mobile. I mean, that's what's going on, and yet we accept it as literal truth. There was a painting of the United States that I had done that was hanging in the Cooper Hewitt for 6 months, and I saw somebody go up to it having a conversation with somebody else and talking about a road trip they took and sort of discussing, oh, and then we went up here and they were following a road on the map that didn't exist. And we're completely comfortable doing it because they had suspended belief because it was sort of right, you know, that it was sort of believable, but it was a lie, you know, it isn't accurate.